Almost a century ago, a stadium was erected in the heart of Forest Hills. Tennis made its home here, and for decades, many great moments were captured every summer in a New York City suburb that hosted our sport's most prestigious prize. It will soon be 40 years since the U.S. Open left Forest Hills, and with it, many of the sights and sounds held by this historic venue. But in recent years, a rebirth, first with music, and then with tennis. A court with a new surface and bold, fresh colors. A new home for a professional tennis team, and this year, a championship final for the league that hosts it. Two franchises from California competing for a trophy that bears the name of a legend of the game. One from Orange County, one from San Diego, led by two great coaches and a team of players, each boasting an MVP from the regular season. Who will raise their game to a level worthy of this hallowed ground, and which team will prevail and raise the King Trophy? It's the Mylan World Team Tennis Finals, presented by Citi. Next. A hot and humid afternoon in New York, temperatures in the 90s, things heating up nicely to decide a championship. The Orange County Breakers and the San Diego Aviators to decide the Mylan World Team Championship here in 2016. The crowd, they're in place. Looking forward to these two teams squaring off to see who will raise the King Trophy later today. Hi, everyone, and welcome to Forest Hill Stadium here at the Westside Tennis Club. I'm Leif Shiras, alongside a Mylan World Team Tetron veteran, Chanda Rubin. And Chanda, two teams, first time we've had two California teams in a final, but both of them have been so consistent. How have they been able to get to this point?
Well, I think apart from the strength of the play of the individual players, it's been the strength of these teams' rosters. You know, a lot of players have been moving in and out of this season with the tournaments on tour and also with the Olympics, and these two teams have managed to consistently get their players to play and gel together and learn how to work through tough times, and that's been a key to the success.
Yeah, they've had some good play from a number of different players, but both these teams so evenly matched. They finished 1-2 atop the standings at 8-4, so you can see how closely matched they are. Significant to note, the Washington Castles, five times a defending champion, they miss out this year. They tie with the Philadelphia Freedoms in third. But how close are they, Chanda, the Aviators and the Breakers? Well, they played four times this season, and it was 2-2.
Well, the big key, though, was the game score, and it was the Aviators who have the slight edge in games, and that's why they were able to have the home court advantage, which is probably going to be big here in the final today.
That's right. The Orange County Breakers were led by not only solid team play, but also the inspired play from their women's singles player. That was Nicole Gibbs, the Stanford All-American. She has had a tremendous season, has really established herself as the player to watch.
Well, and she's been really a stalwart. I mean, she's been the base at times. She's so mentally tough. She's played consistent tennis in singles and doubles and gotten her team through in some big sets, but it's been the mental fortitude, and she's managed at times to pull the team together.
She contributes in singles and in doubles alongside Alla Kudryavtseva, so we'll see her on the court today a couple of times. For the San Diego Aviators, what else can you say? But Ryan Harrison has been brilliant this season. He has really stepped up his play.
Well, sometimes you never know how a player is going to respond in this type of format. A rookie, you could either be overawed by the situation or you could rise to the occasion. And Harrison, he plays big man tennis. He's got the big serve, the big forehand, and he's used it beautifully throughout this season.
Yeah, he's never short on confidence, but he has been playing some fine tennis. He plays singles and doubles alongside Raven Klaassen. So a couple of players to watch here as the Breakers and the Aviators square off for a championship. Trying to make some history here in a historic setting in Forest Hills. Mylan World Team Tennis is brought to you by GEICO. At GEICO, you have a choice of three ways you could save on car insurance. Call 1-800-947-AUTO, go online to geico.com, or stop by the GEICO office nearest you. By Forevermark, less than 1% of the world's diamonds are worthy of the Forevermark inscription. Forevermark, a diamond is forever. By DecoTurf, official tennis court surface of Mylan World Team Tennis and the official surface of the U.S. Open since 1978. And by Citi and the Citi Double Cash Card, the cashback card that means what it says. Well, such a wonderful setting for this championship match. The Orange County Breakers and the San Diego Aviators. I'm Leaf alongside Chanda. Now, a third member of our team is Luke Jensen, and he's down courtside. Luke.
Thanks, Leaf. I'm with the coaches here, and John Lloyd, you know, your San Diego Warriors were outstanding. You got Coach of the Year. What makes your team amazing?
Well, you know, we've had a good combination. We've got a lot of fighters on our teams. Even when matches have not been going our way, they fight. And we got lucky with Ryan Harrison, came in at the last minute, and boy, did he play well. But Raven Klass, an experienced doubles player, and Shelby Rogers, what a find she's been after the end of the quarterfinals of the French. And then Daria Jurak, who's had her best year. So it's sort of come at the right time. They've all hit the peak form right when the season was starting. So I was very happy.
Which player has to perform for you guys to win?
Well, I think all five sets are so important in this scoring. I mean, Ryan Harrison's so confident, just qualified for the US Open. I think when he plays well, the team seems to click. So if I was going to say anybody, I'd bank it in Ryan's favor.
Thanks, Lloydie. Okay. All right, last year's Coach of the Year, Rick Leach. Now, your team is on fire. You set the lineup. What was the key there?
Actually, John set the lineup. But, it comes down to everybody playing well, everybody contributing, and it's team sport, you know, so hopefully everybody plays well today.
But the conditions, you've got a lot of stuff going on, both mentally with the last Grand Slam at the U.S. Open coming up. How do you keep your team focused?
Well, these are experienced pros, and they all went to college except for Ala, and so they know what the team concept's all about. And so, we're hoping that Nicole can carry us through. She was MVP of the league, so hopefully she can carry us tonight.
All right, Captain. Back to you, Leaf.
All right, thanks, Luke, and thanks, Rick and John. Their efforts to get these teams here, you cannot take that lightly. The coach is so important, and obviously the San Diego Aviators setting the order of play. So we'll start off with mixed doubles tonight, then women's singles. That'll be a good one. Nicole Gibbs and Shelby Rogers. Men's doubles, another good one. Women's doubles, boy, all of these matchups are great. They're closing things out, the Aviators, with their best player, Ryan Harrison. He's going to take on Denis Novikov, who has also had a fine season. Young American playing well for the Breakers. So really, Chanda, there are so many great matchups tonight.
Well, and you can see why the Aviators kind of set that lineup with the women's single second, try to get the team ahead depending on what happens in the first set, and then the strength in Ryan Harrison at the end.
So here's just a reminder of the World Team Tennis format. Two men, two women, the one coach, five sets of tennis. Singles, doubles, and mixed. Remember, each of the sets to five games. The nine-point tiebreaker, a little bit different, Chanda, and that could come down to a single point to decide it.
A single point to decide games and the final score in the match. So a lot at stake in those three all points, and you want your strength there at the end, because that could end up being the match that decides who wins it all.
Ryan Harrison, Shelby Rogers. Pretty easy to stay warm today in New York, I can assure you that. Temperatures in the low 90s and the humidity very high as well.
You can see both teams, though, some smiles, certainly looking relaxed out there. I mean, this is what you play for, to be here playing for the trophy at the end of the season. Both these teams have worked so hard, and they understand, and they've been able to play through some of these big moments. And as we look at the rules, the no ad scoring, that's what we talked about, which makes it, you know, so key in those three all points, cumulative game scoring. So every game counts. Substitutions are allowed, a little bit different than what we see regularly in tennis. And lets are in play, and that has taken some getting used to for some players, but both teams well used to that now, and on-court coaching makes it very interesting.
Yeah, the lets are in play. Obviously, you see that in junior tennis, you see it in college tennis, but these pros definitely have to adjust to being away from that kind of rule. That's an adjustment. Does the let go over the net softly? Does it pop up? Remember, in doubles, a let can be taken by the player at the net, so a lot of exciting moments can develop off the let. So many of these innovations we see in Mylan World Team Tennis make it onto the pro tours. Maybe one day you'd see the net court rule? What do you think?
I don't know if we'll see the net court, the let court rule, but we've certainly seen coaching on the women's side. They're still, you know, trying to figure out if they want to have it be there permanently, but also having call reviews. That's been a big innovation as well, and something that's, I think, been a very positive force throughout tennis throughout the year.
Chance now to go to our Forever Mark MVPs. Some great performances this season. No more so than Ryan Harrison and Nicole Gibbs. One reason why these two teams
been able to reach the championship match. Harrison in singles and in doubles alongside Raven Klassen.
We can't underestimate how much confidence these players get from playing team tennis and succeeding in this format and being forever marked MVPs, and that's the icing on the cake.
Yeah, wonderful recognition, acknowledgement, the Forever Mark MVP Awards. Great season. Just remember, there will also be a finals MVP awarded by Forever Mark. We'll have that at the end of the match. Looking forward to see which player is able to play their best today.
So will they get another diamond if they are the finals MVP?
That's a lot of diamonds.
That's a lot of diamonds.
Well, they've earned it, I suppose. Such a beautiful setting to see this dynamic colored court in this historic facility. It just really is a beautiful sight.
Well, you first walk into these grounds and you get a sense of the history that has taken place here, playing from the grass courts to the clay courts to the hard courts. And you know, for me, being the first time coming here a few weeks ago, I've been awed by it, and learning more about the history has been fascinating.
Yeah, built, we mentioned in 1923, it's had a wonderful capacity, so many championships decided here, but recently it's been a rebirth, a renaissance, as they've had music shows here, including Mumford & Sons, over the last few years, and some of the other musical acts, Dolly Parton, Paul Simon, Bob Dylan, Nile Rodgers, Van Morrison.
I know who most of those acts are. I'm dating myself, right?
It's been some great stuff happening here at the stadium, and they've been able to sort of renovate and reinvigorate this wonderful facility. I'm so glad it's still here. It really is a museum to tennis. And now we're adding another page to its history by having a Mylan World Team Tennis Championship here.
And it's a fabulous setting for tennis and for this Mylan World Team Tennis Championship, this final. Crowds rolling in, feeling a little bit of the atmosphere, and that's what's important for the players.
Yeah.
To play to that atmosphere, to use it to help them get through some of these tough moments. You know, neither team has home court advantage, but you have to go out there and feel like you're playing at home from the very beginning.
Interesting, the U.S. Open moved to Flushing Meadows in 78. The last men's champion, Guillermo Vilas, the last women's champion here, Chris Evert. It's great to see. Former Mayor Dinkins here, a great fan of tennis, great supporter of the U.S. Open, and privileged to have him in attendance today.
And he loves his World Team Tennis, and thinks the format is just fabulous, seeing men and women on the court at the same time, playing equally, at every set, every game, every point counting. And if you know Mayor Dinkins at all, you know how intense he is and how much he believes in tennis and loves it, and it's fabulous to see him out here.
So Raven Klassen, Daria Zurak for the Aviators. Across the way, Alla Kudryavtseva, Scott Lipsky. The Aviators, as the home team, also get to serve first in the third and the fifth events. Sweet return from Lipsky. He's another Stanford All-American. They've got a couple of them on the breakers. Here's Raven Klassen, the veteran out of South Africa, having his greatest season as a doubles player inside the top 10, 33 years of age. Doing some great things on tour and in WTT.
And this first game is such a key to get on the board, to establish the lead or hold serve if you are the Aviators.
Daria Zurak, she's also having a career year on the WTA, fourth season. Zagreb, Croatia. She's also played well. You know, it's funny when you say, well, which of these two teams, which player stands out? Well, in many ways, all of them do because of how consistent they've been playing at a high level. Oh, yes.
Well, any team or any player that gets to a final, they're in a rhythm. And everybody out here can hit the ball. They're confident. They've won sets. They've, you know, come through some tight moments. And points like this one, I would expect to see a lot more of them. Back and forth at the net. Great hands from Zurak at the end.
That first volley was deep. Kudryavtsev couldn't handle that. Kudryavtsev, a very accomplished player in her own right. Not only in doubles, but also in singles.
Fossen trying to put a little bit more on that second serve, created the double fault there, but still has a little bit of breathing room at 3-2. There's a bit of wind today, and it's blowing from the Aviator side to the breaker side. All the players will have to continue to take that into account.
Wait, please, thank
you. The service line is the chair. Thanks.
Yeah, classic. First serve. Lipsky saying. Yeah, it's a little bit long, but no change in the call. So the first game goes to the Aviators. Here's another look at it.
Of course, we don't have review on this court, and it's tough to tell from that angle. Scott Lipsky had the better viewpoint.
Lipsky's the veteran of the four. I guess that's my code for saying he's the oldest guy on the court, but one of the nicest guys as well. Originally out of Merrick, New York, just down the road. Another close call. Goes the Aviators' way.
Lipsky not very happy after that last serve, feeling like that was out, and then now his shot being very close to the line.
Ala's originally out of Moscow, still resides there. Kudryavtseva played for the Austin Aces last year, that Austin Aces franchise owned by Lauren Abney. They came to Orange County this season. So Ala stuck it out, and she's been rewarded. They were in the championships last year, losing to the Castles. So Lauren Abney has to be excited about being here with his breakers.
Excellent service game from Lipsky, holding in very strong fashion. And that's one of the keys to playing together throughout the season. You understand where you need to be, when you need to move, and Kudryavtseva on that last point moved over very quickly. They didn't get tangled up, and there was clear communication out there.
And I like what you said at the top of the show, how these teams have really stayed away from injuries. They've stayed away from outside commitments that have sort of broken up the team. They're really plugged into what each of them is doing. Three career titles, couple this year. So really having a fine season. Yeah, that's where Klassen is so dangerous. He's got great wheels, great hands.
And it's so important to have a partner who's moving at the net as Klassen is doing when you're staying back. Jurek here got a good second serve in, opened it up for her partner.
And the trick is, I mean, obviously the rules of doubles keep it away from the net, man, but it seems like Klassen is everywhere up there.
And especially against the wind, as the breakers are. I mean, they've really got to take some chances, go up the line.
Referee today, he'll be busy, no doubt. Plenty of passion on the court when it comes to moments like this. Roger Pennington. Well, that was a solid game.
Very good serving. Just going to say the exact same thing. Missed the first serve of the game, but after that, she did not give the breakers any openings.
And when you're playing under pressure like this, it's the little things that count, right? The first serves and all those kinds of things.
Absolutely.
She did that well.
Absolutely. First serves, first returns, first volleys.
Balls!
Seeing a lot of movement at the net early, particularly from the guys, and you know, that's been a staple for both of these teams, and it's the reason why, one of the reasons why they've gotten to the finals. They've been more aggressive, point in and point out. Both teams are looking for their openings, not letting that ball get by them, and they have an opportunity to close off the middle of the court. It makes these doubles events, these double sets, so key to the success of either team today. Kujets over there under pressure from Claussen and could not control that ground stroke.
When you were playing mixed doubles, what did you do with Winter? How did you approach having a guy like Claussen at the net? Were you lobbing, going up in line? What were you trying to do?
You have to take some balls up the line, go at him, try to keep him honest when you can. It's not always easy to do, and sometimes you're going to lose those points. You may get yourself out of the point. But you have to make him think, not just let him move to poach every time.
Top of the net. So two games all. Teams will change ends. We'll take a short break. Coming back to Forest Hills. It's the mixed doubles to start off the championship. Not sure you can have a better setting for tennis, for innovation, for a bit of excitement. We got some music going on. We also have a little doubles and Billie Jean King, one of the all-time greats. She won this U.S. Open a few times here on these grounds. She's got her Mylan World Team Tennis Championship here.
I'd like to get Billy an umbrella, though. She needs some covering. It's hot out there. That's a beautiful return. Right at the feet of Claussen. Didn't go for too much, Lipsky. Just made it a difficult first volley.
And Billy won it in 67, 71, 72, 74. You lose count with the slam she has.
Strong serving from Claussen, and it's Kudryavtseva, who's had a little bit of trouble dealing with the pace at times. They're trying to short hop it. Jurek all over it.
Over the years, Claussen has really strengthened his serve, a little more power, a little more aggressive play on the second. One reason why he's cracked the top 10 semifinals at Wimbledon this year in the doubles.
That's nicely done. Jurek very close to the net, but so quick with the hands, kept the racket out in front, didn't give an inch up there.
This summer, Jurek played in the doubles finals in Stanford. She likes the American hard courts. Looking pretty comfortable today.
Fortunately, Jurek missed that ball. She swung at it, but it was going well out off the Lipsky racket. And this is a smart play, not an easy volley to handle.
Double faults today.
Well, that's the exact moment that Claussen double faulted in his first service game. Still has a bit of a lead, had some breathing room. He's the 2014 Australian Open runner-up with Buterak. He knows his way around a doubles court.
Straight ahead and able to finish. Aviators get to 3-2. Yeah, Claussen played with Buterak in that Australian Open. And it's Lipsky who's playing with Buterak at the U.S. Open this year. And, of course, that's Eric Buterak's last run. He's going to retire after playing in New York.
Buterak still be involved with tennis, working players.
There's Lipsky serving. Third season at Mylan. French mixed with the Aussie, the Lotto.
It's nice to see most of these players, though, serving and volleying. Times we see a lot of players staying back in doubles more. And, you know, both of these teams, they're looking to be aggressive. They're looking to take the net away. It's hard to do that when you're serving and staying back.
One, two.
Lipsky feeling a little bit of the pressure there. Opening, slight opening for the Aviators at 1-2.
Yeah, Claussen with pace straight ahead, right at Kudryavtseva.
Just couldn't handle the pace. Kudryavtseva racket did not stay out in front. Managed well on the first volley. See, that racket got behind her. No way to control it.
She's pretty brave to stand in there. Now they've down a break point, second serve. No, the volley's wide. So the Aviators, first break point, and they take it. Double fault in the volley here. Didn't help Lipsky's cause there, so San Diego has got a chance now to close out the opening event.
Well, it highlights just how quickly things can turn. And this match was so close, neck and neck, and just a couple of mental errors from the breakers. And all of a sudden, the Aviators have a chance to close out the set, potentially at 5-2.
See if Daria Jurek can get it done.
And you mentioned it, Leaf, it's the little things that the Aviators have done better throughout this set. And they've served better, more first serves, more first volleys that they've made. And they've been solid at the net. That's nicely done from Kudryavtseva, one of the best returns that she's hit thus far. Got it at Jurek's feet. Gave Lipsky something to hit down on.
And the breakers and Rick Leach with the Geico timeout. What do you think he's talking about right now with Lipsky? Kudryavtseva obviously feels like, hey, we're not out of this.
We're not out of it.
That's break back.
Exactly right. And, you know, with that last point, it's one all. You know, a couple of points go their way. They could be right back in this.
Trying to listen in there on John Lloyd and Clausen and Durek. Pick up too much there. I know that Lloyd is a man of few words. He likes to let his players play. A couple of words, keep it simple.
Point. Multiple shots that could have been winners, and Lipsky managing to keep the breakers in that point. But what a great overhead from Durek. Gave Clausen the ability to close. That's nicely done from Kudryavtseva. Sometimes tough when players, team across the net plays the I formation, but you have to pick your spot on the return. And Kudryavtseva did it, picked it, and just went straight at it. No hesitation.
Yeah, another first serve.
Let me hear you say boom.
Set points for the Aviators. Finish at the net for Clausen. Aviators take the opening set 5-2.
That was an excellent set from the Aviators. That was tough break for the breakers.
Well, you can hear the positive energy down there having taken the opening set. It's a great way to start for the Aviators. They're looking for their first ever Mylan World Team Tennis Championship. Luke Jensen is courtside. Luke.
Thanks, Lee. Daria, what a great way to finish out that set. Huge serves, big overheads. What's really the key to winning those key points?
It's easy when you have a mixed partner like this. When you serve good, he's cleaning all the volleys, so it's easy.
Lots
like
of
that.
Pace from you, using your legs, big wrist snap. I mean, you came out with a lot of passion.
I'm a tall girl. I have to use some benefits of that.
Now, first set, that's always challenging to kick off the team.
Yeah, I think both sides came out a little bit edgy there, you know, and we really wanted to get our team off to a good start. And Daria kept me calm out there. She said, use your athleticism, and that's what I did, you know, and it worked it out in our favor today.
How do you like playing this in this historic facility?
Oh, this is incredible. You know, I've heard so many great stories, and I'm hoping to put a good memory in my memory banks tonight.
Game on. Good luck.
Thank you very much.
Back to you, Leif.
All right, thanks very much. Yeah, you can feel the excitement. These players are pumped up. The King Trophy is in the house. And when we come back, it's women's singles, Gibbs and Rogers. So one set is in the books here in Mylan World Team Tennis Finals. I'm Lee Charles alongside Chandra Rubin. Glad you could be with us. Al Mylan, the title sponsor for World Team Tennis. An important part of it is giving back, particularly to the young people. And in partnership with Mylan, World Team Tennis hosts play days in each of the various markets. You can see the players and the high-profile people that come out to support this and be a part of it.
Billie Jean King always says you never know where the next great champion is going to come from, and what a treat for these young players to be up and close and personal with such great WTA and ATP Tour players, be able to interact with them, get some pointers from them, and also have a bit of fun. See all smiles around, and that's how you get kids engaged and hopefully keep them engaged.
Yeah, it's nice to be around a former world number one like Carolyn Wozniacki, and obviously the Westside Tennis Club, a part of that initiative. Of course, this is where the New York Empire, a new team, the Mylan World Team Tennis played their home matches today, though. It's the championship match. Nicole Gibbs of the Breakers serving to Shelby Rogers of the Aviators. Nicole Gibbs, she's made some real strides on the WTA this season. She's 23 years of age, originally out of Cincinnati, Ohio. Now playing her tennis in Santa Monica, California. of the most accomplished college players ever.
Well, that's a key, I think, for Gibbs, and being able to play in this type of atmosphere in college team environment where there is more pressure, a different kind of pressure. Good job of returning that serve after the net cord. It's Gibbs, who's the more solid player, five-time All-American, NCAA All-American.
Oh, yes.
But it's very different playing for yourself, which there is pressure in any match you want to win. When you're playing for your team and other players are counting on you, that type of pressure is at a whole nother level. And for Gibbs, she has excelled in that type of environment, and it's helped her become MVP this year for Mylan World Team Tennis.
Shelby Rogers to serve for San Diego.
Shelby Rogers, she really announced herself on the scene this year, just 23 years of age, out of Charleston, South Carolina.
Quarterfinals of the French Open. She played some of her best tennis. Big game of Shelby Rogers. She hits big off the ground, forehand and backhand side. She can serve big, but the question is the unforced errors and how well will she be out there consistently point in and point out. That's where Nicole Gibbs has had a little bit of the advantage. She's been slightly more solid. And Rogers is going to have to raise that part of her game just a bit today.
Yeah.
Done from Rogers, took her time, that ball, a couple of quick little steps at the end to get back in position.
Yeah, Rogers has an advantage in power, you would say.
Big advantage.
Bigger, better
power.
Serve. Maybe, obviously, Gibbs, maybe the advantage in movement, speed. She's going to get more balls back.
And understands how to construct points a little bit better, Gibbs.
Yeah.
But those are the kinds of points that Shelby Rogers has to be willing to play. She has the power. She needs to use it, keep going for her shots, but give herself bigger target areas. Don't go for the lines. Make Gibbs play over and over. Done from Gibbs, and she forces a deciding point.
All right, the receiver has the decision. Okay, which court do I want to take it in?
And that's the movement, Leaf, that you mentioned. Gibbs very quick around the court.
Big game, if only to calm your nerves. You hate to go down love too.
That's exactly, after having game point to lose that service game, Rogers did well getting that second serve in and getting enough kick on it to force the error from Gibbs. Help.
The Breakers, second best in the league. The Aviators, third best. Of course, the number one player was Madison Bregmel for the Washington Castles. What a great season. Very competitive at the top with these young women. Great to see all Americans doing so well.
Gives you a lot of confidence for the future of American tennis.
They want to be Chanda Rubin when they grow up.
Be better. And this is where Shelby Rogers, she has to focus on that footwork. Those last couple of points, just a slight slowdown in the feet, creating the miss. And that's what Nicole Gibbs has taken advantage of throughout the season against her opponents. Some good hitting from Gibbs. Let's not say she doesn't have the power.
Yeah.
She can clearly generate it when she needs to.
She's added that sort of facet to her game. I think before she was just, you know, a
little
defender,
more passive.
Bit of a grinder, and now she's going to make Rogers move, and this is where Shelby can sort of get into some trouble. People can get her off balance. They've got some court to hit into. Game points for Gibbs. Of course, Rogers replies with that kind of shot.
Rogers knew that where that serve was coming. It's the basic second serve from Gibbs, right in the middle of the box. Beautifully struck, Rogers.
Oh, nice. Well, she defends pretty well there, that backhand corner. Rogers came up with a nice ball up the line.
It wasn't a bad hit from Gibbs. She kind of hit herself out of the point because she was coming in and trying to get a volley, first volley above the shoulders.
Just a little wide.
That's nicely done from Gibbs. Paying the price, continuing to be aggressive, taking her chances. She was unsuccessful the previous point, but she kept coming. That's a key. Allowing Gibbs to close out this game very nicely.
Yeah, both these players have had some tremendous wins this year. Rogers. Beat Pliskova, Vesnina, Kvitova, and Begu in Paris. What a run that was. So exciting, thrilling to see her do so well.
Again from Gibbs, and the difference on that approach was that she had Rogers off the court and then came in behind it. Kept Rogers off balance, not allowing her to step in and get a good hit.
The taller of the two players, 5'9".
And there's that kick again, getting up slightly out of the strike zone of Gibbs. Trouble controlling that backhand high above the shoulders.
And Gibbs mentioned the good wins. She beat Madison Keys in Indian Wells on the hard courts, as well as Shvedova. Lost to Petra Kvitova in the fourth round. That was a great run she had there.
That's nicely done from Rogers. Showing a bit of consistency of her own here.
It's kind of fun to watch everyone on the Aviators bench up off the seat after that one. And if you played Mylan World Team Tennis, you understand that pressure. You're going through it with your teammates, aren't you?
You are. every point.
Oh, wasn't much room, but she fit that backhand up the line. That was a sweet little ball.
It's such a different feeling for players. Very rarely do you cheer for other players week in and week out. Play so much behind them, winning every point. See Rogers trying to get that little extra kick on that last serve. It came down on it too much, dumped it into the net. Really trying consciously to get that ball out of Gibbs's strike zone.
Down the line, and again the deciding point on Rogers' serve.
Such a smart point from Gibbs, though. That return right off the bat, she put Shelby Rogers on her heels. Rogers served such a big serve, she really hit herself out of the point, and now under tremendous pressure to try to stay on serve.
Comes up big. A first serve and another backhand up the line. She gets a second game on the board. That was absolutely vital for the Aviators. So, two games all, 7-4 in the match score. Sweet little two-hander up the line. Shelby Rogers. 2-all, the women's singles. More of that when we come back. Mylan World Team Tennis has a history of giving back to the communities it serves. And for over two decades every fall, greats of the game have joined forces to support a very worthy cause. World Team Tennis Smash Hits is a celebrity-packed tennis event and auction that benefits the Elton John AIDS Foundation. This year, it's at Caesars Palace, Las Vegas. Andy Roddick, Martina Navratilova, John McEnroe, Lindsay Davenport, and other stars will join co-hosts Sir Elton John and Billie Jean King. Since 1993, Smash Hits has raised almost $15 million for charity. Don't miss this great event on October 10th. Yeah, Smash Hits, that is something that is so much fun to be a part of. We recommend you check it out if you can. It's in Vegas, nice setting, Caesar's Palace. Smash Hits.
This is where Gibbs has to be careful to not try to go toe-to-toe with Rogers on the pace department, point in and point out. She's got to work the points a little bit more. Rogers now with a bit of an opening after coming through two deciding points on her service game. Now has a chance at love two.
Sneak that forehand up the line, doesn't she? It's got a little bit of punch to it, but the location is so good.
Well, it's all about moving the ball if you're Gibbs, not letting Rogers set up and hit the same shot twice. That's a beautiful hit.
Oh.
She had it, Rogers, lined it up beautifully, just overplayed that forehand. Missed opportunity.
Yeah, Gibbs really dodged a bullet there, didn't she?
Again, trying to take that forehand down the line. Catching it a little bit late and pushing it. Didn't get the lift on it. Great point, opportunity for Rogers.
Boy, costly double fault there. Seems like whenever you have a service game with a double fault in there, it can mean trouble. Opening set, it was mixed doubles, and Lipsky had a double fault, and it cost him the set, really. There's a break.
You wonder as well how many times Gibbs thought about those deciding points on the Rogers serve that she didn't get. Putting a little more pressure on herself on serve. And you have Rogers, who is playing just a little more freely. Feels like she dodged a bullet and now has all the opportunity in the world up a break here.
Yeah, Geico timeout by the Breakers. Rick Leach out talking to Gibbs, and that is an important moment just to, you know, gather the forces together, make sure we're all on the same page, right?
And settle Gibbs down just a little bit. You know, she gets excited out there. I mean, she's into every point. She wants to win. She's got to slow down a little bit. Get back to her game.
Yeah, you can see the hard work she's having to put in as Rogers was just laying out the hammer, and there is another big forehand that gets her to 2-0.
A lot of times with a big hitter, you know, you have opportunities early to get on top of them and to create some space in the score, and you don't take advantage of it, and it can really work against you. And Rogers now hitting out on her shots beautifully. It's a good move from Gibbs, but again, she went right up the middle basically with that approach shot. She's not moving Rogers enough, and that's what she was doing at the very beginning of this set. Gave herself a difficult volley. Well done by Rogers. Wow, and so unexpected. We've seen the pace from Rogers, the depth, and then that little touch shot completely taking Gibbs off guard.
So that's 4-2. Boy, this is a big game for Gibbs and the Breakers. Yes, they're facing the deficit, but you want to try and keep it as small as you can. Get another game.
Serve has really let Gibbs down in these last couple of games. Double fault there. She's missed a lot of first serves into the net, not getting up and out into the court. And I really am impressed with the way Rogers is just forcing Gibbs. She's not overplaying. She's still hitting out. She's not pushing the ball, Rogers, but she's giving herself big lanes to hit into and is getting rewarded for it.
right, so trouble for Gibbs, trouble for the Breakers. Double fault seals the deal for the Aviators. Take the set 5-2. And you can see what that does for the match score. It opens up, boy, that's a big advantage. 10-4.
Well, it's interesting from 2-1 in that set for Gibbs and break point opportunity, the deciding point. It was all Shelby Rogers. And you know, that is another bit of a turnaround.
All right, let's go down courtside to Luke.
Thanks, Lee. Shelby, how tough is it when you're playing a human backboard and a feisty competitor like Gibbs?
Yeah, it's tough. I mean, this situation is like nothing I've ever been in before. You know, fighting for your team, being in the finals, it's totally different than just playing singles for yourself. I'm having a blast. I'm really happy I closed it out there and started playing a little better. But she's a fighter. I know we're not done yet.
Where was the turning point in the set where you locked in and then you couldn't miss?
Yeah, I started going through my serve a little more. The nerves loosened up a little bit and just trying to be aggressive.
You had a lead coming in, you extended it, and now you go into the third set. How confident is your team?
Yeah, we're feeling great. I mean, we felt great all season. We just help each other, we give each other confidence. So we got a long way to go, but it feels good.
Thanks, Shelby.
Yeah, thanks.
Back to you, Leaf.
All right, thanks, Luke. Yeah, Shelby has to be so excited about that disappointment for Gibbs and the Breakers. It didn't happen today for her. She struggled a bit with her serve. Couldn't deal with the pressure from Shelby Rogers. Men's doubles is next up. Ten miles east of New York City in the quaint village of Forest Hills, you'll find the Westside Tennis Club. This historic landmark will be celebrating its 125th anniversary next year. And as you walk the grounds from the clubhouse to the courts, you'll see this hallowed place is richly steeped in history. Hosting the U.S. Open until it moved to Flushing Meadows in 1978. Every major tennis legend has memories here, from Court to King, Ash to Laver, Everett to Wade, Connors to Borg. And one of the few clubs in America to feature all four playing surfaces, now with a newly refurbished stadium court, and as home of the New York Empire and the Mylan World Team Tennis Finals, the Westside Tennis Club looks to add more history to its storied lore. Well, we're so grateful to be a part of this fabulous facility here with Mylan World Team Tennis, the championships. And that leads us now to Luke Jensen, who's with a very special guest.
A very special guest, the commissioner of World Team Tennis, Mylan World Team Tennis, Ilana Claus. But you're a legend here. You won the juniors here. You won the Open, the women's doubles. You were as high as number one in the world in doubles here. This is a very special place for you.
Absolutely, and it's so great to be back here where there's all this history, and yet we have innovation in Mylan World Team Tennis, and you have the old history of Forest Hills and the Westside Tennis Club. So I think it's really exciting and a really special place for the players to play. They, you know, they play the U.S. Open at the Billie Jean King National Tennis Center up the road. So I think it's just been exciting for tennis to have professional tennis back here at this historic venue.
What's your fondest memory walking on this stadium court?
Well, I think, you know, a couple, but more, you know, it's not really as much the titles you win, but it's really the people you meet and the relationships you have. And I met a family when I was 17 years old, the DePell family. I stayed with them. They became my American family. And so for me, coming back here, I think of my mom and dad who have passed on, but they were here when I won the U.S. Open, my sister's here. So I think, you know, again, I think what I love about Mylan World Team Tennis is the relationships you develop with your teammates, and those take you forever. And I have wonderful memories of Linky Boshoff and I won the doubles here 40 years ago, which is frightening. You had hair in those days. But again, it's the special memories. It's not as much the victories that matter, and that's why it's really phenomenal being back here.
41 years, magical World Team Tennis, Mylan World Team Tennis. What energy here during this final? How do you see this match going?
Well, I mean, the San Diego Aviators came out strong.
Passionate.
Won mixed doubles, won women's singles, but in World Team Tennis, you never know. The momentum can shift pretty quickly. You have to win the last game of the match to win. So trust me, it's not over. And I think both teams were highly competitive during the regular season. They split matches 2-2. I think what divided them was about 8 games. So I think there's still a lot of tennis left to play.
Thank you, Lana. Back to you, Leif.
Thanks very much. And great to have Lana Kloss again, a part of Forest Hills and Mylan World Team Tennis to be a part of it as well. You can see some of the champions of the past. Such a distinctive history here before we move to Flushing Meadows for the U.S. Open. 1978, did that happen? But this is the setting now. Two events are in the books. Men's doubles is up next. The Aviators have captured the opening two. Back with more in a moment. A dominant baseliner who plays with an unwavering will to win, Venus Williams is one of the timeless champions of our sports. A former world number one in singles and doubles, Venus holds 7 Grand Slam singles titles, 16 Grand Slam doubles titles, and 5 Olympic medals, of which 4 are gold. Making her world team tennis debut in 2000, Williams has played in 11 WTT seasons. In the 2012 Mylan World Team Tennis Finals, she prevailed in a decisive tiebreak to help the Washington Castles complete their 2nd consecutive perfect season. Always one to give back, Venus regularly makes time for kids and the fans who adore her. Venus Williams, one of the queens of World Team Tennis. Yes, Venus Williams, such a great advocate for Mylan World Team Tennis and for all the benefits and charities that surround it. So let's look back on what's happened so far. Mixed doubles and women's singles were the opening event. Having a fine season.
And this match came down to a couple of points in the middle of this set. It was on the Lipski serve, and they finally got that break of serve right here. This is where the Aviators really opened it up. And they were able to serve for this first set. Set point here, and they were just too solid, particularly at the net, moving. They were the more aggressive team, the Aviators, and they took that first set 5-2.
Women's singles with Shelby Rogers against Nicole Gibbs. We just watched this, and boy, Shelby Rogers, after a couple of close games that she just got through, deciding points, she really settled in nicely.
Well, this is one of the moments where it turned around 2-1 for Gibbs of the breakers, and deciding point, it was the second one of the set for Shelby Rogers on serve, and she was able to win that one as well. And then she kind of ran away with the set a bit. She got more confident, was hitting out on her shots. The double fault a couple of times from Gibbs at some key moments. Looked like she was pressing just a little bit too much, but it was Rogers who had too much power and was consistent as well throughout this set.
Yeah, it was a real combination of good play from Rogers and a couple of loose points here and there for both Lipski in the mixed and Gibbs in the singles. And boy, it can get away from you quickly. 5 game sets, no ad scoring. Boy, Aviators out of the blocks like an Olympic sprinter here, 10-4.
When it's just 2 breaks of serve, if you think about it,
yeah.
But it's a 6 game differential, and it's because of the format, and it's because of how the games are cumulative, and Aviators really with a head of steam here.
And men's doubles is next, and this is an impressive pair in Lipski and Novikov, but they're up against the number one team in the league, Harrison and Claassen. So the Aviators might have a slight hedge here. I think you're going to need to have a good set of tennis. I know Rick Leach would look to Novikov and Lipski to at least keep this close. Don't let the deficit get any larger. Here's Ryan Harrison, our first look at him today, who's, boy, having a great summer.
He's one of those guys, Harrison, that so much was talked about, you know, as a teenager. He's the next up-and-coming player and had some excellent results, and then just sputtered a little bit. Struggled with the confidence as well, and seems like he's turned the corner on that.
Wonderful play, and we've talked so much about the guys out here today, but Denis Novikov has had a fine season, and you can see the kind of tennis he's been playing. an overhead smash from the baseline.
He's been one of the more solid players, Novikov, and he's really taken to this format as well. And here he's so aggressive. He's gotten more confident as the season has gone on in both singles and doubles.
He's tall, he's strong. That's some work. Klassen had to work hard just to get that point.
Now this is an indicator of the type of points we're going to see when we're in for a treat. High quality points thus far.
What a beautiful place in the world he lives in, Cape Town.
Absolutely.
Sensational place in the world.
One time I've visited and I've wanted to go back ever since.
Yeah, there's Novikov. How are things in Louisiana? Everything on the up and up, getting better?
It's getting better. Good. It's getting better. Still some folks struggling with the floods and trying to rebuild and even just get the process started, but getting there. And that's a big point from Harrison there to try to keep his team in this game and hold serve to start this set. It's been some smart playing from Novikov. He's gone up the line on Klassen a couple of times, and that's the key. That's what you need to do. With someone who's trying to move and poach a lot. It's a big, big serve.
Here are the rankings. As we mentioned, the Aviators, best in the league.
And that last point, you kind of see why. A huge serve from Harrison to get himself out of a little bit of trouble.
If the ball is down, goes past the net, man, you just go forward and try to make him look at you. It doesn't matter if you don't take it, but make him look at it. Let's
go. Yeah, that's some expert advice. If the ball's down low, just move in.
Create the pressure.
Exactly. Whereas Rick Leach knows a thing or two about doubles, a former world number one.
I'm going to pop up middle and on the lift. He's not going to get down my line.
Nice air.
And you just feel like Klassen saying he's not going to go down my line. So if Harrison gets a good first serve, will he make the move? Let's see what he does. See if there's a signal here. A little eye formation. Already got the plan in place. Oh, ho!
Didn't need to have much of a plan after that serve.
Wow.
That is some heat right down the middle. There's nothing Lipsky can do about this serve.
And Harrison is a player who's been ranked inside the top 40 before. You know, his rankings dropped down, but to see him play that kind of point just tells you a lot about the level of confidence he has right now.
And that's the danger when you have Klassen at the net there. Harrison getting that return in, and Novikov, who we've talked a good bit about, only 22 years of age, with some good height on him. His first this season. He's been one of the standout players.
Playing a doubles team that is moving a fair amount, I think you have to move yourself. And I think that was an expert move by Lipsky to get out there and let him know that we're equally as aggressive out here.
All right, cut off some of that court. Smart serving from Novikov as well, moving that serve around the box. Not just going for the big bombs.
He's the veteran out there. He'll be the quarterback of that team. I think Novikov feel comfortable about the thing he wants to be doing out there. Uh-oh, that's not a good sign for that. Some double faults today have been a problem for players. Very hot conditions, very bright out here today. Rick Leach won a title with St. Louis, the Aces, back in 1996.
That's a good recovery from Novikov, focusing on that first serve, not letting himself get to a pressure situation, having to throw in the second serve.
And I think that's why people speak so highly of this youngster, Tom Gullickson, and some of the USTA guys who help out Dennis Field. He's got upside, and he does. He can play very strongly from the ground. I think he's learning a lot about the game this season, particularly doubles, having a guy like Rick Leach around you. There's a lot of professionalism in this league, and it's great for young players, great for veterans.
It's great for development. Give you these matches that you're playing against top players. Playing in pressure situations, which helps to hone your game. And as you mentioned, playing singles and doubles, and that's the key, I think, to developing, particularly when you're trying to gain that confidence, you're trying to get over the hump, win bigger and bigger matches. And having the ability to transition, to play at the net, that gives you so much more confidence.
This time it's Harrison taking the middle. Now Harrison had a win over John Isner this summer up in Toronto. Lost a verdict in the third round. Another reason for the kind of confidence he's putting on display here today.
Big serving from Claussen. Not just the guy at the net.
John Lloyd's looking for his second title. He won one with the LA Strings back in 1990. He was a player coach then. Matt Lipsky was waiting on that one. And you talk about leaving that racket out in front. He kept it out there, took it early. Not miss by much.
This is where you see the experience of the Aviators, just keeping that sustained pressure in the match, in the set right now. Holding serve there very comfortably. You're putting the pressure right back on the breakers. And they're down in the count, and they're down in this set. And it is key for the breakers to hold serve here. Up a break of serve, and you're up in the score, you can afford to hit out on a few returns, and Harrison struck that one beautifully right at the feet of Lipsky.
Yeah, won a qualifying match at the U.S. Open this morning. Here he is on site. Trying to wrap up a title for the Aviators. Couldn't ask for a better day if he was able to close this out.
That's a pretty good day.
Well, if the tennis doesn't work out, he's got a future in football in Europe. Oh. Yep, everything he touches turns to gold for the moment.
That's a smart return. Stretched out wide, Harrison didn't try to hook this shot back cross court, but went right up the line, just the right moment.
Again.
You have to appreciate how beautifully on balance Ryan Harrison stayed on that volley. He was trying to poach. He moved to his left, but then was on balance so he could make the adjustment back to the right, and looked like it was so easy.
Well, Harrison stayed with it. Novikov was defending the net, but in the end, the Aviators just a little too strong.
I think we need a little better chest bump than that, though.
I got to clean it up. We need to get Luke Jensen out there to advise on the chest bump. Back at Flushing Meadows Stadium, a lovely view. You can see the grass courts behind the stadium on the left, the hard true on the right. Such a wonderful facility. Great to be right here in Forest Hills, New York for Mylan World Team Tennis Championship action. I'm Leaf alongside Chanda. Luke Jensen is down courtside. Hopefully get some comments on the last chest bump to see how they could improve. Ryan and Raven on the last chest bump. Of course, Luke and Murphy did a few of those in their day, winning Roland Garros. The Bryan brothers stole the chest bump from Murphy and Luke.
You always have to have a generation that keeps elevating what happened the generation before, and definitely see that with the Bryan brothers.
So nice lob there from Lipsky, trying to make something happen for the breakers here down the 1-3 deficit.
The risk and go up that line, cannot become predictable, especially with Claussen moving up there at the net.
Now Novikov was targeting the right location, straight down the center. Just found the tape instead. I formation again from the Aviators.
That's smart playing, smart volleying from Harrison. Making sure he doesn't overplay, he's hitting the right shots at the right time, playing for that second ball. There's a couple of game point opportunities here.
Welcome everyone, those of us joining us here at Forest Hills from Winston-Salem. Temperatures in the high 80s here in Forest Hills, New York. Things heating up pretty nicely here for the Mylan World Team Tennis Championships in the midst of the third event, and the Aviators have built a fine advantage. I'm Leif Shiras alongside Chanda Rubin, and this has so far been all about the Aviators. They won the first couple events and now lead in the third event, the men's doubles.
And in every event, it's been a couple of points here or there that's been the key difference, and it's resulted in a big differential at 14-5. But the breakers, they've been right there. A few double faults, missed opportunities on the return, and now Novikov serving under a bit of pressure at 1-4.
Yeah, Dennis Novikov alongside Scott Lipsky. Ryan Harrison returning at the top of your screen alongside Raven Claussen in the doubles. There's Ryan Harrison. He was a busy man this morning, having played qualifying match over in Flushing Meadows. And he had a win there, so he is on a roll.
He's got a lot of confidence, Harrison, and early in this set, he was down a couple of break points and came up with some huge serves to get his team out of trouble to stay on serve, and that was a bit of a turnaround in this set. But it shows you how big of a difference confidence can make. And when you're feeling good, when you're in a rhythm of playing, a rhythm of match play, plus you have the talent that Harrison has, can be a devastating combination.
And these are a couple of moments for the breakers where they really need to be sharp, be at their best. Remember, every game counts. Cumulative scoring for the final result. All five events, all five sets are added up to decide our winner.
And with the no add scoring, you know, those big key deciding points can be huge in the course of each event. Those last few points from the Aviators, you know, those were probably the loosest points we've seen them play all set. And they made a couple of unforced errors, pretty easy unforced errors early in the point. Can they pull it back together here to serve it out?
Klassen with a finishing touch. Ranked inside the top 10 currently, semifinals at Wimbledon. He's had a brilliant season, the best of his career. Trying to add a Mylan World Team Tennis Championship to that resume here today.
Well, it's Klassen who is the more experienced doubles player. He's won Grand Slams. He's top ranked, but Harrison, he's been pretty impressive at the net. He's been solid up there. He's looking to move. He's got that racket head firmly behind his volleys, and he's held Klassen in a couple of these games as well.
They're doing so many things right. These are set points coming up.
Just too solid, too aggressive from the Aviators.
Oh yeah. What a set of tennis. They're trying to improve their chest bump. They did pretty well that time. They practiced at 3-1. Now they do it and get it right at 5-2. So you can see what it does for the match score now. The Aviators in command, 15-6. This is going to be a tough deficit with just the two events remaining. Got women's doubles, where the breakers are number one in the league, and then men's singles to wrap it up. So the Aviators have got themselves in a nice position. All right, let's go down courtside now to Luke.
Leave, we have some champions down here. Co-founder of World Team Tennis, Billie Jean King, and the mayor of New York City, David Dinkins. My partner in a charity event, Roosevelt Island championship team right here. Billie, what do you think about this match?
Well, I think it's great, except it's usually much closer because as we were talking earlier, you know, there were two matches apiece going into this final. And so the first time ever we've had two California teams. And quite frankly, then they had to go to game one and the Aviators came out ahead. So that's why the coach John Lois decided on the order of play. So, I mean, I'm surprised that it's not closer so far, but you know what? It's never over in World Team Tennis, so you don't know. I mean, it depends what happens these next two sets.
Mayor, you're a huge tennis fan. What do you think of World Team Tennis?
What do I think, what?
What do you think of World Team Tennis?
Oh, I love World Team Tennis.
It comes all the time.
But you see, Billie Jean and Alana have done so much, not just for World Team Tennis, but for instance, this stadium would be dead were they not here? And obviously,
back, huh?
Yeah. And Forest Hills has a lot of history, as you know. And I came out to the inaugural match, and I thought it was just beautiful. The court looked good, the stands looked good, people in the stands. And this is very good, not just for those old tennis nuts like me, but for our children. Kids become better people through tennis. They really do.
Thank you, Mara. Thank you, Billie Jean. Back to you, Lee.
Team!
All right, thanks very much. Great to see the mayor and Billie Jean King courtside. Glad you could be with us. We've got women's doubles coming up next. Mylan World Team Tennis is brought to you by GEICO. At GEICO, you have a choice of three ways you could save on car insurance. Call 1-800-947-AUTO, go online to geico.com, or stop by the GEICO office nearest you. By Forevermark. Less than 1% of the world's diamonds are worthy of the Forevermark inscription. Forevermark, a diamond is forever. By DecoTurf, official tennis court surface of Mylan World Team Tennis and the official surface of the U.S. Open since 1978. And by Citi and the Citi Double Cash Card, the cashback card that means what it says. So this is what it looked like so far. Mixed doubles was up first. Klaassen and Jurak, boy, they were sharp early, taking on Lipsky and Kudryavtseva.
They were so aggressive to start this match, and it was tight until this point where Lipsky, a couple of loose points, he double faulted, he got broken. And then it was the Aviators that were able to run this set out.
Yeah, 5-2, they took that one. Then it's women's singles. Shelby Rogers taking on Nicole Gibbs, an All-American affair. And these early moments were so important for Shelby just to stay in it.
Well, a couple of deciding points on serve for Shelby Rogers, and she was able to win both of them. This was the second one, and this was a bit of the turnaround in the match where Gibbs was up 2-1, an opportunity to close it out. She didn't close it out, and it was Rogers who turned the table. She was helped along by some double faults and some unforced errors from Gibbs, but it was the pace, the power, and the depth that got her through.
Men's doubles, Klaassen and Harrison. Boy, that was a deciding point. Harrison was just a bomb down the tee and real indication of just how confident these guys are.
And Harrison, he saved a couple of game points early in this set, and that seemed like a turnaround at that point. Here's set point, and it was the Aviators who were more aggressive, more confident, and that chest bump got better as the match went on.
Yeah, that was a key for them. You know, when they're chest bumping well, look out. But they won the first three events. The breakers need something good. And the women's doubles are off and running. First point to Gibbs and the breakers. There's Nicole serving first alongside Alla Kudryavtseva.
For the breakers to try to have any chance to turn this match around, stay in this competition.
There's Daria Jurak playing alongside Shelby Rogers. Because yeah, remember, the team that's trailing in the match score still has a chance to win. The trailing team can win the last event, but obviously, it'd be nice if the breakers could keep it close. If it goes into extended play, you need to make up those games that you're behind. Here's a reminder of the rules, no ad scoring. Remember, every game counts to the match score. Substitutions are allowed. Lets are in play. See the occasional GEICO timeouts. That's so the coaches can speak directly to their players. Well, that's a big game for the breakers.
It's a key right now for the breakers to not only win this set, but to try to win it as comprehensively as they can,
yeah,
to try to close the gap in the score just a little bit. Coach Rick Leach of the breakers giving this team some encouragement. And John Lloyd, the Aviators, very successful coach of the year. Well done.
Right on top of the net, Daria Jurek. She's having a career season on the WTA, and she has played brilliantly this season in World Team Tennis.
And she's been so aggressive at the net. The movement and the mixed doubles is where it started, and she's picking up right where she left off.
Ace from Rogers down the tee, and you can see behind the players is a shot clock. You've got to get the point started. 25 seconds, and you feel like so many innovations from Mylan World Team Tennis have made their way onto the Pro Tours, and you wonder, okay, is that the next innovation?
It's been in discussions, and some players are very much for that. Make it very clear.
See it in the back of the corner, up in the corner of your screen. Things keep moving, Team Tennis.
That's right on the line.
Yeah, Gibbs.
Lucky for Jurek, who was right there. This ball hopped right over her racket. Helped Rogers in her singles match, single set against Nicole Gibbs a little bit earlier. Big serving, great placement. Got her out of trouble a few times.
Yeah, another big serve. Gets a game on the board for the Aviators. Here in the fourth event, Shelby Rogers, we mentioned, such a brilliant run at Roland Garros. Alla Kudryavtseva in your picture, the Russian. She's a doubles expert. She was Rookie of the Year last year, Alla Kudryavtseva, for the Austin Aces. And the Austin Aces moved their franchise this year to Orange County. So she's been in this position before, and so has their owner, Lauren Albany. He'd like to be getting over the line. But it's a precarious position here with the Aviators up 16-7.
It's very tough under the gun. The Breakers trying to stay in this match, give themselves a chance. The sense in the singles that, you know, Nicole Gibbs, she's so important to this team, to this Breakers team. She brings so much energy, you know, so much positive energy, and felt like she was just pressing a little bit too much in her singles match. As we see, the one of the first casualties the day is the sign. Got to get that fixed. But, you know, it looked like Gibbs was pressing just a little too much, and, you know, just a little bit of a lack of confidence, the same confidence that she's had in the teeth of some of these matches throughout the season. And it was Rogers who was the more aggressive player, who's the more consistent player. And she actually moved a little bit better in the end than Nicole Gibbs.
Yep.
And so for Gibbs, you know, she has to kind of turn that around, try to find a way to really pump herself up in this doubles and give her team a shot.
And she's a great competitor, a great warrior. Let's go to courtside to Luke while we have a moment. Luke.
Hey, John. I'm telling you, man, coach of the year this year, your team's rolling. What's been the difference?
Well, what a start we had. I mean, everyone is just fired up and everyone's nervous, but in a good way. And I've never seen such tennis. They started off, but it's like we needed a good start. I was hoping we'd kind of be solid the first two sets, and we just went out to this unbelievable lead, and now they're playing catch up. It means they're forcing the action, and we're doing great.
We're in a historic place, Westside Tennis Club. You played here. Any memories?
Getting thumped by Bjorn Borg here.
Is that
a good man on clay?
Yeah. Everybody got thumped.
Well, that's true. At least it was quick and merciful.
Thanks, buddy.
Thanks.
I think a lot of people could say they got
Some issue about the score, whether it was 3-1 or whether it was game.
Yeah,
and it's game.
It is game.
Orange County leads 2-1, 4th sets.
Umpire Pennington.
You got to lead 16 games to 8.
Stance corrected. Score is right. Jurek serving. She has served brilliantly today.
Nicole Gibbs, along with Coach Rick Leach, got that ball. That serve was long. We don't have replay here, so it stands. Opportunity for Kudryavtseva, didn't get enough on that second serve. Popped it up and Rogers took advantage of it at the net.
Oh, Kudryavtseva. One last reflex to win the breakers the point.
One of the best points of the set. Great reactions from Kudryavtseva. Excellent movement from Gibbs. And then in the end, just what the breakers needed. Kudryavtseva thought Gibbs was going to poach on that ball. Wasn't quite ready for the ground stroke. And it's been Jurek who's been so solid from all areas of the court. She's serving now for the game.
All right, so 2 games all in the women's doubles. The Aviators 17-8. With plenty to see at this stadium. Some remarkable spots here at Forest Hills Stadium. Built in 1923 with a capacity of over 13,000, Forest Hills Stadium was a mecca for music and tennis, hosting the U.S. Open until 1978 and staging concerts from Bob Dylan to The Doors to Simon and Garfunkel. The true character of this place, however, lies beneath its walls, deep in the underbelly of the portholes behind the stadium court. Speakeasies abound behind masked doors and secret entrances, and those lucky enough to gain access will find treasures at every turn. A bar, a lounge, a private respite for VIPs, musicians and their entourages to relax, unwind, and listen to the music. And on this day, perhaps, to watch some tennis. World Team Tennis Finals at Forest Hills, the perfect marriage of history and colorful innovation. The championship match, the King Trophy is in the house. Lets are in play, and that's the first time I think I've seen that this season where the net player can get involved.
And that was a great play by Jurek. She was ready for that ball. Made it look very easy.
Not a bad try. There was a little bit of space there. Kudryavtseva was moving a bit to the center.
And that's what Kudryavtseva has done so well throughout the season. She's had that movement at the net. She's created the uncertainty in the returner.
Kudryavtseva, you might remember, had a win over Maria Sharapova at Wimbledon back in 08. Huge upset. There's some space.
that's what Nicole Gibbs does so well. That forehand up the line, we saw it time and time again in her singles when she was successful moving the ball, and there in doubles, very effective.
The Aviators finishing that off.
You can sense with the Aviators every point, and they are just so in tune with each other. They want to win every point. They're trying not to give an inch, and they're keeping the pressure on the breakers. Every point is so hard fought, and when you're down in the score as the breakers are, that can start to weigh on you a little bit. It can weigh on your confidence. That positive energy becomes harder and harder to come by.
Tennis Novikov there on the bench. He's in the orange cap. He's going to play in the men's singles, the last event against Ryan Harrison. Oh, yeah. Rogers doing some good work at the net. Here's a deciding point.
And the key for the Aviators is, you know, even if they don't win this set, if they keep it close, then the breakers will not have eaten into that deficit.
Yeah.
And it's almost like it's a wash in the set. Breakers really under the gun here.
Oh, there it is. A break for the Aviators, and it's 3-2.
And that's just the pressure of the moment from Kudryavtseva. That's a volley she could have hit 9 out of 10 times. She tried to overplay it, felt like she had to do more than she really needed to.
Pressure now on the breakers, immense. They need to find a way to get back in this.
Where Kudryavtseva will be on these next returns. That last shot, overplaying it again, missing well wide. Another tough miss from Kudryavtseva.
Just slipping away, you feel, for Rick Leach and the breakers.
That's a good point for the breakers to win. Looks like they were out of it in the middle of that rally. Managed to squeeze a win out of this point. Can they use something, find something to get them going, try to get the break of serve back and keep their team in contention?
High formation, the Aviators. An immediate overrule from Roger Pennington in the chair.
It's the first of the day that we've seen from him. Interesting time to overrule.
Well, he must have got a good look at it. It was on the near sideline, so they'll play it again.
The Aviators are in such good position. I don't think they'd worry too much about anything right about now.
Yeah. breakers to 2 points all.
And somehow, some way, the breakers have won those last 2 points when it looked like they were out of it. And that's the type of play that they need right now. Just keep themselves in it somehow, and maybe something good can happen.
First serve, so important for Rogers there. The right play from Gibbs. He just couldn't execute it.
And everything going the way of the Aviators right now. And that's the time in just about every set that they've gotten the break of serve, really opened the score line up, and this women's doubles is looking like it's going the same way.
A great return.
And it can be so tough when you allow a team that can strike the ball as well as the Aviators do, when you give them a big lead. It's so tough to make that up.
Yeah, they're just not showing any doubts over there. A little bit of time and they're making good things happen.
It's such a big difference when you can hit out freely and you feel like you have the space, you have the room, and you have the confidence to do so. And that's what the Aviators are doing. Rogers is striking the ball so well throughout both of her matches, both of her sets. It's really the breakers that have felt the need at times to overplay and overhit, and that's what happens when you're down and you feel like you have to do more
exactly.
to get yourself back in the running.
Yeah, desperation can be a great inspiration, but it can drive you to do too much as well. Set points for the Aviators. Now, and they take the set 5-2. That is a significant play for San Diego. They're trying to get a step closer in just their third year as a franchise to perhaps take home the King Trophy. They put themselves in a great position, having won the first four sets, all 5-2. Incredible development. Let's go down to Luke.
Dari, another unbelievable performance. Dominant with the serve, dominant with all the power. First set in the mixed doubles, now in the women's doubles. Big difference in any of those two sets.
You know, I'm just inspired with my partners today. That's all what I can say. In singles, so Shelby played and good comeback. I mean, volleys, she improves match by match, so it's beauty to play with her.
But what about Shelby? You're hitting everything, winners all over the place, but you break the sponsorship sign. What's that?
I know, I saw her moving, I tried to go line, I was a little late, I crushed that sign, but I've had so much fun playing with Daria. She helped me there in the first couple of games. My returns were struggling a little, but she's taught me so much, and that was a blast. Happy to get that W.
Now, Daria, it's so interesting, because during the regular season, this team against these guys, you're 2-2. It was so close. Today, it's domination.
Yeah, we had some tactical things to do with the coach, John Lloyd, so he said to us what to do exactly, and we corrected the things which are very important for us, and like you see on the results, we completely did it 100% like he said.
But what are those things? You can't be so vague. What are those specific things? You're winning, you're cruising.
I will tell you when we win afterwards.
Thank you very much. Back to you, Leaf.
You don't want to give away those secrets. They've obviously figured it out. Four sets of 5-2. Final set coming up, the men's singles. This is what we're playing for today. The King Trophy. 10 miles east of New York City in the quaint village of Forest Hills, you'll find the West Side Tennis Club. This historic landmark will be celebrating its 125th anniversary next year. And as you walk the grounds from the clubhouse to the courts, you'll see this hallowed place is richly steeped in history. Hosting the U.S. Open until it moved to Flushing Meadows in 1978, every major tennis legend has memories here, from Court to King, Ash to Laver, Everett to Wade, Connors to Borg. And one of the few clubs in America to feature all four playing surfaces, now with a newly refurbished stadium court, and as home of the New York Empire and the Mylan World Team Tennis Finals, the West Side Tennis Club looks to add more history to its storied lore. Well, it's such a wonderful place, and Mylan World Team Tennis so happy to be here at the West Side Tennis Club, hosting the U.S. Championships for so many years before the move to Flushing Meadow in 78. Some of the first things happened here, the tiebreak, equal prize money. They had night play as well. 10 Davis Cup finals, many of those on the grass courts here. There's also a WCT Tournament of Champions. I played in that one. And look at the many concerts, some of the great groups that have been around. Frank Sinatra, Rolling Stones, Jimi Hendrix, The Who. Pretty exciting bit of history. And you can see this wonderful facility now for concerts. Really is something special. This opened again in the summer of 2013 after decades of being in the dark. There's Katrine Adams, president of the USTA. She played a few years of Mylan World Team Tennis.
Just a few. Very successful professional in the WTA Tour and in Mylan World Team Tennis as well. Fabulous to see her at the helm of the USTA. First player to ever be in that position, former player.
So Novikov and Harrison to close things down, the last event. Remember, Novikov and the Breakers, they are the trailing team. If they can win the last set, well, they still have a chance to win it. Mylan World Team Tennis Championship, Tom Leaf alongside Shanda. Luke Jensen down courtside, Denis Novikov. Up against it today is the Aviators have won the first four events. Ryan Harrison is playing with a lot of confidence.
Well, Novikov has so much work to do here. Not only does he need to win this set, but he needs to try to win it comprehensively enough to eat into this the deficit, and then he's got to keep winning games.
Yeah, Letzer in play.
Needs about 12 games to Ryan Harrison's zero.
Yeah, it would be an incredible run of games. The biggest deficit made up in extended play was 6 games. But this would be a difficult proposition for the Breakers and Novikov, who, despite having a great season, is that's certainly asking a lot. Oh!
The key for Novikov here is just not to get ahead of himself. As we see the rankings, Ryan Harrison first in Mylan World Team Tennis this season. Phenomenal play that he's had. And for Novikov, he's just got to put his head down, hold serve, try to get some opportunities to win this set, and just then go from there. Not get too far ahead of himself, not think about the score line and what he has to do to win. It's just important for him, for Novikov, to play his best tennis and leave it all out there.
A sweet return, that last point from Harrison.
That's nicely done from Novikov.
Novikov's had a pretty good summer, qualified at Wimbledon. Got to the second round there. Also second round in Toronto. Federico Delbonis, pretty talented player, the lefty out of Argentina. Lost to Nishikori there.
Wow.
Now that volley bounced down into the ground.
That was some heat on that return. It was so fast that Ryan Harrison didn't even see it once it left his racket. But he likes the result.
So there's a game for the breakers. Here's a look at what's happened so far. Pretty consistent, I think you could say. 5-2, 5-2. Mixed doubles, women's singles, men's singles, women's doubles.
It's been unbelievably consistent. It's been that 2-1 game or that 2-all game where the Aviators have broken just about every set.
Harrison has always had a brilliant serve and a very dependable forehand. I think his backhand's been improved throughout this summer. That last one, you could see he drove it with depth and pace.
Well, we often see players, you know, practicing a lot, and that's a staple, you know, playing professional tennis. It's getting out on the practice court, working on parts of your game, but you can only get better under pressure and in match situations. And that's what we're seeing a little bit of in Ryan Harrison. He's really come alive in this format. Under pressure, he's been able to come through in some big situations, and it's given him a lot of additional confidence, and he's taking that into the U.S. Open qualifying.
Yeah. These guys are just crushing the ball. It's impressive to watch. I mean, Novikov's a strong player. Harrison, the quicker of the two men. But he's got some power as well.
That's big.
I mentioned the power, right?
That is massive. Out wide.
Yeah, that just wasn't spun out there. That was hit pretty cleanly. The team's happy. John Lloyd's enjoying it. It's not too often you sit on the bench in world team tennis and actually feel relaxed.
Well, when you have a 12-game lead, that tends to relax you a little. And it's really a testament to Novikov that, you know, he's staying in there and staying focused on holding serve. Can he continue?
Wow.
That was ugly. That was perfect timing, great balance, power.
There.
This is where Ryan Harrison can just have a little fun. Swing out on a few shots, on serve, ahead in the score, nothing to lose.
Wow. That was a bit of a saber move.
That's
Roger Federer's move.
That's when you're really enjoying yourself out there on the tennis court. Short hopping the serve.
Sneak attack by Ryan.
This is kind of adding insult to injury. You're up already. You're going to return my serve from there?
Another good service game for Novikov and the breakers. Second game on the board. And he gets sort of a mild chest bump as we're on serve in the final event of the evening. It's men's singles. Stay with us. We'll wrap this one up in a few moments. A born showman, Vitas Gerulaitis captivated audiences worldwide with his exceptional court coverage and fascinating flair. The Lithuanian Lion won the 1977 Australian Open singles title and peaked at number 3 in the ATP World Tour rankings. In World Team Tennis, Gerulaitis graced the multicolored courts for the league's first 5 seasons, led the Pittsburgh Triangles to the 1975 championship, and closed out his WTT career in 1978 as the men's scoring leader, playing in front of his hometown fans with the New York Apples. Always one to give back, Vitas was the inspiration for the league's free racket program, which provides thousands of kids the opportunity to take up the sport he loved. Vitas Gerulaitis, one of the kings of World Team Tennis.
A great moment to remember Vitas Gerulaitis. We miss you, Vitas. So we make our way back here to Forest Hills. Ryan Harrison serving now, 2 games all. The Aviators in command. Great return. Can Novikov make a move here with a start like that? See the strength, the timing on the returns that he possesses.
Well, some players, you know, after Ryan Harrison tried to short hop that serve, might have said, you know what, I didn't like that. So I'm going to try to do some things on my end to turn this around. And Novikov certainly has the ability. The tough one Harrison's throwing in serves like that one. He has served so well in some big moments throughout today.
Yeah, that was an absolute rocket right down Main Street.
Had his racket on it, so much pace, just couldn't control it. A couple of game points for the Aviators, for Harrison.
After it, failed to convert, so here's a deciding point. So far, this is the 5th deciding point of the night. San Diego's won all 4 of the previous. At 5 of 5 now. One reason why the match score is 23-10.
And a little bit of a missed opportunity there from Novikov. Had his racket on it.
Here's a look at the past champions. Well, the big news, I guess, this season in many ways, we're going to crown a new champion after 5 consecutive titles by the DC Castles. They also won it in 09.
The dominance of the Castles has been unbelievable. This last handful of years.
2-0.
And they were almost there in the running this year again to try to make the final, but these two teams we've been watching today just played impeccably.
Let's see why this man is thought of as real possibility. It's got some tremendous potential. 6'4" tall. It's got a little easy power.
That's big.
Fred Ludd, the owner of San Diego Aviators. Jim Ault on the right, the GM. Boy, and Fred, that's got to feel good.
They're pretty happy right now. Everything's going the way of the Aviators. Harrison just hold serve, and the Aviators will be able to close this out.
Yeah, there was a franchise here in New York, the New York Sport Times, owned by Claude Oaken. He was the CEO. He sold the franchise to Russell Geiser and Fred Luddy. Relocated the team to San Diego. They became the Aviators, and here they are. Just in their third year on the verge of a first title. Pretty exciting.
It's hard to imagine Ryan Harrison not holding serve. Even if he gets broken once, it's just not going to be enough still with serves like this one.
Exactly. Even if Novikov forced extended play, there's plenty of room for Harrison to shut it down. Rushing serves.
Ball.
Boy, another ace. That's six aces.
Novikov looking just a little bit dejected there. We can certainly understand why. He's not playing a bad set at all. Just not able to get his racket on some of those balls.
Now, confidence is that one intangible that you don't have automatically. You really have to earn it. I feel like Harrison has done the right things this summer. Playing a lot of winning tennis matches, as you said. Success under pressure. We're getting more success now.
And it's all Novikov can do to just hang in on serve. And he's done that. You know, he's done what he's supposed to do in holding serve thus far. A nice volley from Harrison, and that's testament to the doubles that Harrison has been playing. Got over to that volley, didn't overplay, played for that second ball to put Novikov in a difficult position, and it paid off. Hitting from Novikov.
Yeah, Harrison hoping for a little bit of help on that call on the baseline. Pennington, who actually gets along pretty well with everyone under pressure, says not that one caught. All right, so four games all. And it's Novikov who's had the best experience here tonight. Time now for a 9-point tiebreak. Don't forget, go to WTT.com/online. You can connect with all your World Team Tennis favorites, the players, bios, results from throughout the season. So four games all, a 9-point tiebreak. First 1-5 will take the set 5-4.
breakers must win it if they want to get to extended play.
Good play from Harrison, serving and volleying, practicing that move in the transition area. And these are the type of plays that will pay dividend for him the rest of the season.
Indicator how evenly matched these guys have been. At that point, Novikov went toe-to-toe with Harrison. He's got just as much power.
Yeah.
Got speed around the court. And it's more of his ability to anticipate Novikov. Puts him himself in good position time and time again and has a bit of an advantage here because of it.
Yeah, 3-1, they'll change ends. Couple more points for Harrison on his serve, and then three final points for Novikov if he needs them. The breakers trying to make the best of this one, obviously supporting their man on the slim chance he can win this set and force extended play.
And there's a little bit of pride on the line as well. These have been two best teams this season, and certainly the scoreline today is not indicative of how evenly matched they are as a team.
Yeah, the first four meetings, it was each side winning two of them. But tonight, it's been all San Diego.
Are the type of shots that Novikov can't afford at this time. You see him pantomiming, just didn't give himself enough court to hit into.
All right, big into the body, gets Harrison another point. So it will come down to the final 3 points on the Novikov serve.
Time for a double fault that you could have.
Sure is, as brings up a match point for the Aviators.
But if you're going to double fault, follow it up with that serve.
So here's another match point. And a set point for the breakers. And Harrison having a little bit of fun with Novikov. Where is he going to go with it? Oh, what a serve. So Novikov and the breakers take the set 5-4. And the only set they've won tonight. So we do go into extended play. So we'll take a short break, but when we come back, it'll be extended play. Will the Aviators close it out, or is there a comeback in the breakers? Welcome back to Forest Hills Stadium. The Breakers and the Aviators now at extended play. The Breakers winning the last event. Now it's up to the Aviators to win one game. Or if Denis Novikov and the Breakers can win consecutive games to tie the score and force a super tiebreaker. Obviously, the Breakers in a tough position, having to win a number of games in succession. You can see the 11-game deficit. That's a big one to make up.
Be a little tough to break Ryan Harrison five times in a row, which is what Novikov would have to do.
Does a nice job with that forehand.
And I think the key here for Novikov is what he's done in this last set, is just to focus on his game, what he needs to do to stay in this match, hold serve, and you never know what can happen.
To get one game on the board, just explore the Harrison serve.
Yeah, that's a nice play. At just the right moment, two all. Got the first serve in and followed it up with a very aggressive volley.
So there's one game to 14. Now the tough part, breaking the Harrison serve, something he didn't do over the course of that final set. Kind of a wry smile from Novikov, as if to say, okay, I'm just trying to climb Everest here.
He knows he's up against it. Nothing he can do about it. Set play each point. And that's a bit of a bolo forehand. Whip the end of it from Harrison. Got so much spin on that ball, brought that ball in with still a great deal of power.
With style.
If you were in any doubt as to what the big shot of Ryan Harrison is, obviously the serve, but that forehand is a huge weapon.
Championship point, and the San Diego Aviators have won it. They will raise the King Trophy here in 2016. Excitement for the players, excitement for the ownership group as well. Just 3 years since the move to San Diego, and they are raising their first King Trophy. An amazing achievement, really.
And well-deserved. And they played such solid tennis throughout the day. Obviously, Harrison closing it out, but it was a team effort, and everybody played their part. They took their chances when they had to. They were aggressive when they needed to be. And they were the team that were was just a little bit more solid, especially in those big moments.
Yeah, deciding points today was a real key for the Aviators. They won all the significant ones. And it came down to Ryan Harrison, the MVP of the league, of the Aviators. And again, just impossible to break his serve.
The serve was so huge from Harrison throughout the day. And when he needed that extra point. He came up with the big serve at just the right moments, and that's not easy to do, even for a big server, to serve well when you most want to, and that was one of the things that was so impressive about Harrison today.
Yeah, Harrison in his first year, Shelby Rogers in her first year. Raven Kloss is his fifth. Daria Zurak, her fourth season. So a lot of young players with a bit of veteran leadership. And of course, John Lloyd, the coach at the helm. He's been down this road before. So the Aviators add their name to this impressive list. They break the run by the Castles. All right, well, wait a moment. Let's go down courtside now to Luke Jensen.
The MVP of the league in the regular season, and then you really brought it today. I mean, whether it was the doubles, the singles, but a big smile on your face. What was really the tone?
You know, it was just fun. I mean, overall, it's exciting to get out here and play in a team environment. I didn't play college tennis, so outside of Davis Cup, I've never really played on a team before. So to get out here, play with these guys, had a nice lead whenever I got out there in singles, so I was able to relax and kind of go for my shots and have fun with it. So proud of my teammates, so proud of my coaches and all the ownership and staff. Really cool experience being out here.
You were serving so big, but it really started in practice. What were you and John Lloyd, the coach, going over in those buckets of serves?
Yeah, you know, we did that all season before every match. You know, my game starts with my serve. If I can serve well, then it frees up the rest of everything I'm doing. You know, we just spot serving, working on hitting the different types of serves, whether it's flat, whether it's spin, whatever it is. And then, you know, just having a guy in my corner like John Lloyd, who's got the experience he does to, you know, see any little thing that might go off. Really appreciative of everything he was able to do. And last but not least, thank you all to all the fans for coming out. We really appreciate all the support and love all season. It was a lot of fun out here. You guys made it really special, so thank you all for coming.
Now, what does this mean to you, the team, the city of San Diego?
Oh, yeah, it's great. I mean, the city, you know, we played at the Omni La Closter Resort. It was a super cool little setup we had there. You know, I guess San Diego hasn't really had a first place pro team of any sort ever, I don't think. I'm not sure if that's accurate or not, but that's what someone told me on our staff. So, you know, it's really cool to bring in the King Trophy there, and hopefully we can bring some more in the future.
Congrats.
Thanks.
When we come back, the King Trophy presented to San Diego.
Mylan World Team Tennis has been brought to you by GEICO. At GEICO, you have a choice of three ways you could save on car insurance. Call 1-800-947-AUTO, go online to geico.com, or stop by the GEICO office nearest you. By Forevermark, less than 1% of the world's diamonds are worthy of the Forevermark inscription. Forevermark, a diamond is forever. By DecoTurf, official tennis court surface of Mylan World Team Tennis and the official surface of the U.S. Open since 1978. And by Citi and the Citi Double Cash Card, the cashback card that means what it says. Thank you, everyone. Two wonderful California teams. They brought their West Coast rivalry to New York. Congratulations to the winners and to both teams for such a remarkable season. My special privilege now of introducing the CEO and the commissioner of Mylan World Team Tennis. That's Lana Kloss.
Thank you, Leif. What an exciting end to the 41st season of Mylan World Team Tennis. And let's give a hand to both these teams who played their hearts out today. I would like to thank a bunch of our sponsors who, without them, none of this would be possible. So to Mylan, GEICO, Wilson, Forevermark, DecoTurf, and Citi, who's our presenting sponsor, thank you so much. We're extremely grateful. A shout out to the ball kids, the volunteers, the officials, and all of our tennis family that are here today supporting us at this great historic facility. I want to thank the players, not only the two teams who are here, but all of the players who played Mylan World Team Tennis this season. Their commitment and dedication to their communities and their teammates is greatly appreciated. I also want to wish all of them the very best of luck as they drive down the road and start the greatest tournament in the world on Monday, the US Open at the Billie Jean King National Tennis Center. This court and Forest Hills has crowned some amazing historic champions, and today we celebrate a new champion. Our 2016 Mylan World Team Tennis Champions, the San Diego Aviators. Give it up for them.
Hey, thanks very much, Lana. And now a chance to acknowledge our finalist team, Orange County Breakers, and have the distinct privilege of introducing the president of the USTA, Katrina Adams. Katrina, who will will hand over the finalist plate. And I believe it's to Rick Leach, the coach. Congratulations, Rick. In the battle for the King Trophy today, this player made his mark for his team. Forever Mark, a diamond brand from the De Beers Group of Companies, will present today's finals MVP with a Forever Mark diamond. Less than 1% of the world's diamonds can carry the Forever Mark promise, a promise that each is beautiful, rare, and responsibly sourced. The 2016 Finals Most Valuable Player Award, presented by Charles Stanley of Forever Mark, goes to Raven Klassen of the San Diego Aviators. Congratulations to Raven Klassen. Raven, congratulations. What does this mean to you, to San Diego?
Can I just, I've been part of this organization from the start, and they've really been great to me. I wish I could split this with the entire team, because today, fortunately, things went my way, but they've carried me through some tough times, and thanks a lot to the team there. This one's for you guys.
All right, congratulations, Raven.
Congratulations.
Thank you very much. I appreciate that.
All right, congratulations, Raven. All right, well, let's hear from the winning owner now, Fred Luddy. Fred, congratulations. Come on over. Talk about what this means to you. I know you've been 3 years now with this team, and suddenly great things are happening for you guys.
Well, you know, the quality of the character of our team is just incredible. And I think, you know, they played so well as a team, and I'm just so proud to be associated with them. And I hope everybody out here just had, you know, half as much fun as I did watching this whole season, because it was just fun from start to finish.
All right, well, congratulations, Fred. Best of luck next year. Will you be back to defend it?
Of course we will.
All right, best of luck and congratulations. A chance now for Lana Klaas and Billie Jean King to present the King Trophy to the San Diego Aviators. Congratulations again to the new champions of 2016 of Mylan World Team Tennis, the San Diego Aviators. A brilliant way to wrap up the season and the championship match here at Forest Hills. What a dominant performance by the Aviators, winning 4 of the 5 sets and winning it in extended play. Another brilliant season, the San Diego Aviators wrap it up. They break the run of the Washington Castles. For Luke, for Chanda, I'm Leafs, and for everyone at Mylan World Team Tennis, we'll say so long for now.